Hey guys, how you going? Back again today with another video, and I hope you're all doing well in quarantine now through these tough times. I know everyone's struggling in the world right now, so I hope that you're all safe, you're feeling healthy, and you're looking after yourself. So yeah, let's get on to the video. Now in today's episode, I'll be going over the top 5 most overrated football boots on the market in 2020. So that's all the boots now that are currently released and are available for purchase. So these are the top 5 most overrated football boots, at least in my opinion. And if you own any of these boots, I'm not saying they're bad, I'm just saying that they're a little bit overrated, and there are probably better options available on the market currently. So let's get straight into the video. At number 5, we have the Nike Phantom Venom. Now the Phantom Venom, when it came out in January 2019, was a great boot. The Venom brought back those T90 laser vibes, which we all used to know and love as kids. And but for me personally, there's just something about them that doesn't feel quite right when wearing them. The striking pads aren't that prominent. They are quite slick over the top and feel like it's basically just a band-aid on top of the boots. There's not too much grip or not too much power being generated from those essentially striking elements, which aren't really that prominent. So for me, if you're spending $290 Australian, it's much better to go and grab yourself a pair of Vapors, or if you have a wider foot, go out, grab yourself a pair of Nemesis 19.1, because for me personally, I think that those two are better options than the Phantom Venom. In number 4, we have the Phantom Venom's brother, the Phantom Vision. And for me personally, again, that ghost lacing system, that whole quad fit technology with how you pull the laces tight and the whole boot just wraps around your foot. For me personally, it's a little bit too bulky. I did have a pair of the Phantom Vision 1s. However, now with the recently released Phantom Vision 2, there's not much difference. It's basically just a graphical update. They're pretty much the exact same boot, apart from a few minor tweaks, like they've extended that kind of striking grip and made it more of a half-half design, or kind of one third of the boot has got that kind of triangly design and the other side's kind of just that grip. But for me personally, I am more of a fan of the Vapors, as you guys know. So don't spend your $320 Australian on a Phantom Vision. I think the Puma Future, I think they're the 5.1s now. They just released 3 colorways, so you have the blue and the black, the yellow and the black, and the blackout midnight colorway. I think it's called the Eclipse Pack. So I think that's a much better boot if you do have a wide foot and you want to wear something that's comfortable. I think definitely spend $280 on a Puma Future 5.1 that was released this year instead of the Phantom Visions. Sorry all you Phantom fans, but for me, it's just not quite the boot that appeals to what I like to wear. I like to wear something that's a bit thinner. That ghost lacing system, we have the lace cover, for me personally, just doesn't cut it. It's basically bulk for nothing, so Phantom Visions, not for me, but that's why they're overrated. Coming in at number 3, we have the Adidas X 19 Plus. Now, as you guys know, you can't beat a lacing system, so obviously there has to be a laceless boot on this list. They are $350 Australian, which is a lot of money, and you're essentially paying an extra $60, which is a lot of money, for a pair of boots that don't have laces compared to a pair that is better, softer, and offers you more responsiveness for $60 less. Go spend $290, get yourself a pair of Adidas X 19.1s. They are so much better than the Laceless Plus model, and you'll find that they fit your foot so much better because you can give those laces a tighten. Yeah, they're just so much better, so much more comfortable because you can adjust the fit. So that's why I believe the Adidas X 19 Plus are overrated, because a boot that's cheaper in the same range is better. So prices and everything, go grab yourself the Adidas X 19.1, not the Plus. In second spot now, moving along, still into Adidas, we have the Nemesis 19 Plus. You guys probably saw this coming. Again, the Nemesis 19 Plus offers that laceless fit, which if you are a laceless fanatic, I do believe the Nemesis 19 Plus is maybe a touch better than the X's. However, I believe they're more overrated because the Nemesis for me is probably up there with one of the best boots in the Adidas range. So definitely go for the Adidas Nemesis 19.1. It's got that low collar fit. As you know, me personally, I do not like the collar on a boot. So it is a low cut, more of a traditional fit. It's a little bit more comfortable around the ankle. For me, the 19 plus kind of comes up a little bit too high on the foot. The 19.1, obviously you can customize the fit around your foot, you can tighten the laces, and you can adjust them however you like. Fine slippage around the ankle, you can do a runner's loop, which you can Google and obviously just do that. It's pretty simple to give you a bit more lockdown around the heel if you're like me and you really like your lockdown around the back of the boot. So that's something you can do. But for me personally, the Nemesis 19 Plus, while it is a decent laceless boot for an extra $60, is it worth it to go laceless? I definitely think no. So get yourself a pair of Nemesis 19.1s if you are looking at the Nemesis range. Stay away from the laceless ones. Get the laces and you'll have a good time wearing them. And just before I get to number one on the list, I thought I would throw in some honorable mentions. These boots could have been on the list, but they just missed out. So I reckon I'm gonna have to throw in the Adidas Copper range, including the Plus and the 0.1. For me, they are just a little bit overrated, but if I had to choose one, I would definitely get the Plus, which is strange because normally I'm all about my lace boots and not the laceless boots, but in this instance, I think the Copper is probably the best fitting laceless boot that I've ever put on my feet. 20.1 is a little bit more bulky. It does have that burrito style tongue, which I absolutely hate. I hate burrito style tongues. I know Messi likes them, but I absolutely hate the burrito style tongue. So definitely go and pick yourselves up the 20 plus, which I think looks better, feels better, and surprisingly enough, it's actually a laceless boot that I would wear. It's got nice plush kangaroo leather, so the 20.1 is the one I'd avoid. The 20 plus is the one I'd get. But for me personally, not the biggest fan of leather boots, so that's why I think that they are a little bit overrated. And I'm also gonna have to throw the Puma 1 5.1 onto the list. For me, again, if you're gonna buy a speed boot and you're gonna spend $280, pay $10 extra, get yourselves a Vapor. So yeah, just for me, if you're gonna buy a boot that's got a bit of leather on it, if you want a leather boot, go for the Puma King Platinum. I wouldn't recommend the Puma 1. They are comfortable, they will get the job done, but there's better boots on the market right now for that price point. So yeah, they're just not for me either. And as you guys are probably gonna be shocked at, coming in at number one is the Nike Mercurial Superfly 7 Elite. And that also applies to the Pro and the Academy range. So if you guys are looking at grabbing yourselves a pair of Mercurials, the Superflies aren't the ones to get unless you really like that dynamic fit collar. Now the collar for me, I don't love it. I definitely preferred the collar on the Superfly 6s Elite. For me it was just a little bit higher, which sounds strange, but for me this collar is just maybe a little bit too low because there's no real difference between wearing these and the Vapors. What's the point of paying an extra $30 Australian? These retail at $320 with the Vapors retailing at $290. What's the point of paying $30 extra for literally that much material? If you're gonna pay $30 more, wouldn't you want a little bit more? Kind of like the Superfly 6s had. I think that collar was a lot better. Also, the Superfly 6s were shaped a little bit straighter around the back. The way it kind of curves in here, as you can see, it does curve in a little bit there and there, which does feel kind of a little bit strange and takes a while to get used to. I've only worn these boots a handful of times because I've always gone back to the Vapor. But yeah, definitely the Superfly is and will always be a lot more overrated than the Vapor. The Vapor is definitely your option and the choice that you should go for if you are looking at buying a pair of Mercurials, unless you have to have the boots that Ronaldo, Mbappe, Sam Kerr wears. They all wear boots with the collar, but for me personally, I think the Vapor is better value for money. It's more comfortable, and I think it actually looks a bit better because the low-cut look just looks nice and sleek. Definitely go for the Vapors in all three tiers of the Mercurial range. Go for them in the Elites, the Pros, and the Academies. I think you have a great experience wearing them. So that's it for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be trying to post videos more regularly. I think I'm getting a bit better now, being quarantined away from this virus. So I think I'll be trying to post videos maybe even 2 times a day if I'm lucky. I'm really trying to grind out some content. My goal is to hit 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year. That would just be an absolute amazing present for 2020. So yeah, make sure you leave this video a massive like, you hit the subscribe button down below, and leave a comment. Do you guys agree with my list? Is it right? Is it wrong? Are there any other boots that I've missed? So yeah, let me know.